All right, let's go.
Jared Polin, froknowsphoto.com. Did you know that?
No, that's your address on in the email.
Yeah.
Good.
And I'm here with Lorraine, a friend of my grandfather's. And how are you today, Lorraine?
I'm fine, and I'm so glad we started to talk about this topic because I am the librarian.
Yeah.
And you told me you have all this wonderful information, and I'd like to explain to you how you could make it easily accessible for yourself and for others.
Yeah, what happened is Lorraine asked me what my shirt meant, and I tried to explain what iShoot Raw is, and then when I explained that they're files and pictures and things like that, she started to ask questions about how I file them. Do I keyword them? Do I tag them? Do I put subjects in there? And basically, Lorraine's going to go through how a card catalog worked, being that they don't use them anymore, and the importance of, or what's the important things when you're tagging and organizing your files.
Is to make it easily available. And what you have to do is think in terms of what you want in that information. Supposing you're taking a picture of something. Number one, you could file that picture under the subject. It could be the subject under place or the topic. Or if you want to file that under, an author or an artist who created that particular bit of information. And this would enable you to find it easily. In the card catalog, things are arranged by the subject of a book or a disc or all types of media today. We have all types of media in the catalog, not just books anymore.
I never understood the card catalog. Can you explain to me the basics of it?
Yes, I can. Supposing you had the name of a book and you wanted to know if the library had it. So you could look it up in the card catalog with the first line that you're looking for would be the title. Now, supposing you didn't remember the complete title. If you had the author's name, you would look them up by the last name of the author and then with the first name, and you could find the book under the author's name. So that there are several ways in which you can look this up. You may even want to look it up under the publisher's name. Who was the company that published
this
particular? And all of this information is in your card catalog, with other things as well, with the date of that the book was published, the copyright date, the name of the publishing company that published it. The catalog is a wonderful tool to use to locate information. That is really its purpose, because the information, if it just sits there, is not worth anything. It's only worth to the person who is looking it up and who knows how to access it.
So it's important in terms of photography. Say if you go to Paris and you want to tag your photographs with Paris, it's important to put the date, the location, the subject. What else is important there?
Well, you have all that information in there, and also maybe you would want to put the location. Supposing you're talking about the Eiffel Tower.
Right.
You might want to put down the location of that particular place, or the Arc de Triomphe, the location of that. So that's another thing. You want to know where that place is. As a photographer, you need a little bit more information if you want to access that information or go to that particular place.
Yeah, because how it works on the computer is we can search the same way that you had your card catalog. We can search for dates, locations. We can search for pretty much everything because I don't know if you know this, but when I take a picture, I've already pre-programmed the camera to put in my name, my copyright information, my phone number, my email address.
Oh, that's
so
wonderful.
It records that information, so I'm the author. That's in there. And then on the computer, it's really important when you're going into put it into the computer that you say this photo was taken here and this is the subject, like you said, butterflies,
right,
or flowers,
so
that you can search, do a quick search and come up with everything related to butterflies.
Right, absolutely. You want to make it as easily available. Availability is what we really need with information.
So that we don't bother the librarian every 2 seconds. You have to do your job right so that we don't bother you.
And well, that's what we're there for, to be bothered.
I bothered the librarians all the time.
Because
I was too late. I'm like, I don't know how to use a card catalog. Can
that's
you find
fine.
It for me?
We're only too happy to help you.
They didn't like helping me.
Well, the librarians that I worked with, we worked with children.
Okay.
And so they did expect you to help them, and it was a pleasure to help them.
Good.
So that it was a help to them. Also, you might want to put in your email address. Do you have your email address mm-hmm. in there, too?
Yep, when I take a picture, it's on every picture.
Yeah, well, that's good, so that they can get in touch with you if they want and ask you more questions about the particular subject matter.
Yep.
Well, they may even be able to suggest other things. Let's say in Paris, some people may have different places that they really liked.
Yeah.
And they may want you perhaps to take pictures of that. Mm-hmm. So they certainly can add that to the file as well.
That's all good information. It's as relevant as it was in
then,
the early...
always.
And it's still relevant today. Even more relevant because we take more pictures and we need to organize because organization is really important. File naming, tagging, organizing, it's the same as...
And I think with the computer, it's even easier than we use the card catalog.
I still don't get the card catalog.
You still don't get it? Well,
no, they're gone. Like,
they're
I never
gone,
knew which
yeah.
one to look in.
Well, the drawers are marked alphabetically. The card catalog starts from A to Z.
But the funny
thing... And outside of the drawer, there is a guide that tells you what letters... are encompassed in that particular drawer.
We said no snoring, and he's over there sleeping.
He looks good. He looks content.
I hear you. Go ahead.
No, I was just saying that the card catalog has the drawer letters on it. However, with the computer, I think it's easier because all you have to do is put in the word.
Yep.
You don't have to look for a particular drawer, and you can pick it up with so many different subjects.
Yep.
That all you have to do is put, I think the computer is much easier to use than the card catalog, and I can understand why it has really taken over for the card catalog. Because this is an easier way to access information. And that's the main thing, is we have to access the information that we have. And if it's just sitting in the computer or in the card catalog, it's of no avail to us. We have to be able to get it and then use it for whatever purpose we want.
All good information.
All right, good.
Really
I'm
good.
I'm looking forward to seeing some of the things that you have actually used, the idea of the card catalog, but through your computer.
Yep.
Because the computer is a much more powerful tool.
It is.
And we're lucky to have it, really. And it's so easy to get information. Like when I got my computer and I got rid of a lot of my books because I didn't have room for them.
Did you get an iPad?
And I have an iPad, yes. And the thing is that I always like to look things up. You know, it's from my training, really. So I really needed encyclopedias, you know, so that I could look up the various subjects. Yeah. And it's just wonderful. Like, you could even do, if you're doing a play review, you could even put in the name and the author of the play, where it was produced. There are so many topics that you could really use. You have the whole world open to you.
Yep.
So.
Well, there's the phone.
Okay.
Bob's going to jump and get the phone.
Okay.
So don't fall over and don't knock the camera over, please.
Aww.
All right.
Okay.
So we'll end it there. Lorraine.
Yeah, I think we'll end it there. And if you need any other advice that I can help you with, I'd be only too happy to do it.
Thank you so much.
And I want to see some of your productions.
Not a problem. You can look it up on your iPad.
I will.
I'll give you a card.
Okay, very good. It's been a pleasure.
All right, Lorraine,
really.
Thank you.
Okay.
All right, guys, that's good information. There you go, Jared Polin, froknowsphoto.com. See ya.
Great. Bye.